Hey everyone, welcome to Amplify with Jordan Emanuel. Today I'm super excited because we've got my Playmate sister, Miss Felicia Porter, okay?
Yes, using the real legal name, the legal name.
But you can call her Faux. We can call her Faux Pops. Tell the people who you are, what's going on, what do you do, what are you doing?
You know.
Give them the tea.
Playboy, you know, we're Playmate sisters, but Miss Playmate of the Year over here. Well, we're actually technically Playmate of the Years, but you like, I'm gonna consider you the OG though, because you the last of your kind. You know what I mean? I'm gonna give you that title because you deserve it.
The grand finale. Yeah. You know.
basically, I am Miss April 2019 Playmate. I just started modeling when I was in America's Next Top Model. You may know from there as well. But yeah, is that the intro?
America's Next Top Model, how was that? What was that experience like?
It was everything you could think of and more. No, the experience as a whole was such an amazing experience. Tyra was kick-ass. I loved her. Like, people thought she could... She's Tyra, but to me, she's always Tyra, you know? But overall, it was such an amazing experience. I didn't model before that. I was a preschool teacher before that.
Oh my God, I didn't know that.
You know, teaching some kiddos. But from there, I did top model and my career kind of skyrocketed from that. And it was such a beautiful experience. I wouldn't change it for the world. I would do it again and have the same results if I had the chance, so.
So when you were preparing, you know, for your Playmate shoot or just in general, like preparing for a shoot, what is that song that like gets you like, okay, bitch, we're ready?
For real, I have three.
Okay.
I have my newest one is Savage with Beyonce and Stallion.
Okay.
If you don't have jeans on, baby, you don't feel my pain. Like, that's my shit. That's me. And then, I'm Every Woman, Whitney Houston. That's like my like drag song. Like, that's like what, that's like, I want that at my funeral type shit. And then Supermodel by RuPaul.
I knew it. I was waiting for it. I think I've witnessed you playing that on set. So that's where I was like, I was waiting for it.
That's like the number, like if I'm on set and like you really want to get me like that bitch, I'm like, okay, play Supermodel, and then that's where I'm at.
What's a song you're embarrassed to admit that you like?
You're my honey bun sugar plum, pumpy yuppie, you're my sweetie pie.
Wow. What's your favorite music video?
Oh, the two that I was in, bitch.
Okay.
I was in Justin Timberlake, Tunnel Vision, and I was in Usher's Good Kisser.
I did not know this.
And I was a video vixen in both, so please go check it out.
How did Playboy come about for you?
I am the only girl of technically five brothers. Twin brothers are 15 years older than I was, so they already had Playboys like stashed out. And I always felt like Playboy was never a taboo. It was always just, you know, nudies. You know, I basically grew up with them. I collected them once I got old enough to collect them. And for, I would say it happened all in like a month. I saw one of my homies, Brooke Powers. I always talk about her. I saw this like whole imagery with her and she was just like, oh my God. You know, she was, to me that was badass. I mean, it's still so badass to me. So I remember being like, babe, I want to do it to my husband. I want to do Playboy. I would love to do Playboy. And girl, legitimately like 2 weeks later, I had that little like, the bunny head with the emblem next to it and my DMs, slid into my DMs. Christy, love you.
What? I didn't know that.
Yes. It was
sliding in DMs.
Christy out here. No, Christy was the one who found me. And it was like, would you be interested? And like my whole life was like, ooh, like manifestation where like everything happens in like kinetics and kinetics, I should say. But it just, that's how they reached out to me and I was like, hell yes. I remember literally having to fight for that title though. Mm-hmm. I had a few agents who weren't super, they were supportive, but I had to kind of work in that message of Playboy is no longer the 90s. And not that it was bad back then, it was just of the time, you know?
Yeah.
But so much more woman forward now. It's so much more like, you know, about us women, and we have trans women as well. And we have women that are bionic models, so to speak. Marsha, Miss April, I think she's 2020. And it's just, the platform is not just for the one type of woman, it's every woman. I am every woman. Whitney, rest in peace, girl. Just kidding. We are that, though. We are the Playmates now, or are that.
I think that's a conversation that I have a lot too, is people are so used to the former shell of itself, you know what I mean? And haven't really caught on to how it's manifested in such a greater, more empowering situation. You know, there was still an interview a couple freaking weeks ago about somebody talking, you know, their little hate, whatever. And it's like, okay,
you get that,
whatever. Girl, everybody has their different experiences. Ultimately, I just feel like, you know, we created a family. I feel like the best part for me was definitely like meeting the other Playmates. Like,
totally,
they really have been such a part of my life.
Yes. I'll take into consideration.
And they're like friends. Yeah, like, and even the crew too, you know what I mean? Yeah. And the people that work there, it's insane. So
I totally
you can't beat it. Shout out to our Playboy family, you know, get their merch, get their little paper, get their little cute stuff.
Buy the calendars. We also, do you have your shirt? Do you have a shirt out? I got a shirt.
Or I got one on Misguided, but it's like this. It's like my lips. I'm like, damn, I couldn't get a little eyeball, nothing.
We'll get you. I'll talk to some people. We'll talk to some people. We'll make some shit.
Your people will talk to my people, and we'll get my face on something.
Our people will talk to each other.
I love it. And are you still, you know, shooting and doing shoots?
Yes. So I'm still working. So I want to just put it out there because I haven't really announced it yet, but I moved to New Mexico, where I'm from. So I still fully work out of LA. I'm still fully present in LA. I'm there like literally 2 weeks out of every month. So yeah, life's changing. I'm being an adult now. I bought a house, about to try and have babies. So yeah.
On your grown and sexy.
Oh, you know, she's young. He's young, dumb, and full of vision still, so we're still keeping it real. Just kidding, no, but yeah, we're... Next move is literally just to keep taking care of myself, taking care of my family, and I think that's what 2020, that's all anyone could do after that year, so...
Yeah. Absolutely, just live your best life. So thank you so much.
Thank you, girl, I love you so much. I'm just gonna say to all your people out there too, is like... When I first met Jordan, like me and this bitch, like we just clicked. Like you have to know, we just clicked. So I'm very honored and proud of everything you've done. Aww. With or without the, you know, the Playmate of the Year title. Like you're just a genuine person, and this is my bitch right here.
So, thank you. I love you.
You're amazing. So I love you. Thank you for having me on.
We're gonna do a dramatic reading where I read lyrics. And you have to tell me the artist or the song.
Oh, bitch. Can you make it easy?
The 23rd of Loneliness and We Don't Talk Like We Used to Do.
Oh, now this DLC.
The 23rd of Loneliness and We Don't Talk Like We Used to Do.